You're the Alpha, you're the finisher. Yes, great peace of faith. Great peace of faith. Lord, we thank you for the peace of God that passes all understanding. You said that great peace of faith that love your law. Nothing shall offend them. Oh, you're the Alpha, you're the finisher. You're the Alpha, you're the finisher. Oh, God. Every good and every perfect gift. Oh, it's coming from above. It all comes from above. Verses anew every morning. Oh, great is your faithfulness. Oh, we thank you, Lord, that your covenant. Oh, you said you will never break it. Hey, by the ultimate thing that have come out of your mouth. Oh, God. That means that you will stand behind your word. Yes, you will stand behind your word. And you will perfect that which concerns us. You're the faithful God. That keeping covenant. Hey, you said you would never leave us. Hey, neither would you ever forsake us. And that you would be with us always. Hey, even to the end. Oh God. You are compassionate high priest. Merciful and compassionate, faithful and true. Hey, you keep in covenant with them that fear you, that walk before you with all of their heart. Oh, you'll never break it. Hey, your covenant you will never break. Oh, Allah. Like the ultimate thing that has gone out of your mouth. Oh, God, we bless you. Hey, we bless you, glory, because we can count on you, we can depend on you, we can always trust in you. Hey, faithful are you that have called us, and faithful are you that will do it.
Even our faith. Oh, my.
not a forgetful hearer, but a doer of the word. Oh, that man shall be blessed. Lord, we thank you. Oh, for your blessings. The blessings of the Lord make it rich. Hey! The blessings of the Lord make it be rich.
Liberty of the bruised.
You keep my mind. You guard my heart. You keep me in perfect peace. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Satan is a liar tonight. Satan is a liar. There's no truth in him. Hallelujah. The word of God is true. The word of God is life to them that find it. It's healing to all of our flesh. Hallelujah. Jesus' name.
Just talk with you this morning, 2 minutes, but we just want to
have a few praise reports. I know Sister Panola hasn't had a chance, and we're going to give her a chance tonight and Sunday.
Thank you, Lord. Great blessing. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Yes, receive her. Anybody else that has a new year,
I'm sure God has done some things for us since we testified last. So just feel free to just share the witness of the Lord. Amen. Sister Panola, Washington.
Thank you.
I would just like to give a testimony that the Lord has blessed me. I moved here in September, and I really started looking for a job like maybe October, and trying to get into retail again and everything, and all the retail places, I mean, just denied me. Every last one of them, I was like, oh, Lord. And so a couple of people said, God got something else for you. So I've been volunteering over at OSU Medical Center downtown, and I was, you know, using that as my ministry, helping people, serving and everything like that. And so I applied, kept applying for jobs there. And thank God, one of the jobs I applied for finally interviewed me and hired me for the job. It's a 3D 11 shift, but amen, once I start writing, I need that night shift. So God is just so good, and He may not give you what you want when you think you want it, and it's because He got something better for you. And so that's all it was. He had something better for me. And He's always been so good and so gracious and merciful for me, and I just love the Lord for that. And I just try to just keep myself in a position for Him and keep myself humble to Him, because I know where my blessings and my strength and everything come from. And also on top of that, I would like to just ask everyone to pray for me. I just lost an uncle on last Friday with cancer, and so his funeral is this week. And also I just been binding and praying against that spirit of cancer, because in the last 6 or 7 years, I've lost like 7 family members on mother and father's side to cancer. Mostly on father's side, 5, you know. And so I bind that spirit and I cast that back to the pits of hell. This will be the last family member that passed with the cancer. And I just ask that you all will keep us lifted up in prayer. Thank you. Amen. Good. All right. Anybody else have a testimony or something that you want to share?
Amen. This is a time that we can give out our praise reports. Amen. God is good. Is there anybody else? All right. Just want to say that we want to encourage you to continue to meditate the scriptures. Is the barrel machine didn't work, did you?
Yes, it did.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, just give me a copy. Give me a copy. Last few weeks, remember, we've been focusing very heavily on the Lord's compassion. I mean, how many know that, I don't know whether that message has gotten through yet, that God is for you, and full of compassion, slow to anger, and that He's not a withholder, and He wants to get His richest blessings, amen, released into your life. Amen. Thank you, Sister Pearl. Amen. And give one Sister Panola. Everybody else should have a meditation book. And we're having some meditation books run off. If you want to turn to chapter 7. And so I thought that we covered, laid the foundation. You know, this is the foundation that we need to establish in prayer. Amen. You need to have a strong message, you know, a strong foundation in God's love and God's goodness. And as you begin to praise the Lord, those expressions that relate to God's compassion, God's goodness, all of these things will begin to go through your mind. And these things are the things that we can begin to release, and it makes you really, really, really happy. And it really helps to build you up in your prayer, because prayer is all about building ourselves up on our most holy faith.
as we pray in the Holy Ghost. That's what prayer is all about. So you have to extract from the scripture the parts of the scriptures that will do the best job in terms of getting you established in the love of God. The love of God, because that's the area of the word that will build your faith higher than any other portion of the scripture. We have to really have a solid foundation in God's willingness to come to our aid, willingness to help us, willingness to release his blessings and his fullness and all that he has provided us through his death, burial, and resurrection. Amen. We got to convince ourselves that God is for us. And we've given you a lot of scriptures. One scripture, the Lord God is a sign and shield. Amen. That's Psalms 84, verse 11, I believe. And he gives grace and glory. And no good thing that he will what? Withhold from them that what? Walks upright before you. How many remember that scripture? If I begin to quote it, then y'all can finish it. His eyes are running what? What is he looking for? Looking for those hearts, that's what? That's open. Amen. Those hearts that have placed themselves in a position where his blessings can get to them. Amen. That's what he's looking for. Amen. Amen. And we mentioned about the Lord has pleasure in the prosperity of his what? Servants. So you have to conclude that God is for you big time. Amen. He has pleasure in the prosperity of his servants. And there's another scripture we said it's God's good pleasure to what? To give you the what? Give you the kingdom. Yes, yes, yes. See, those scriptures should resonate consistently in your mind as you pray. And as you think about them, it helps you to even pray more effectively in the scripture. But if you don't have a frame of reference when you pray, your prayer is not going to be that deep and it's not going to be that meaningful to you. You got to have a frame of reference. And you got to tie God to every good and perfect gift. You got to tie him to that. Amen. And when you begin to reflect on that, that's the thing that caused the release to come. And that's the thing that caused you to flow and enjoy the fullness of your, amen, worship, amen, with the Lord. The scripture says in his presence, there should be what? Fullness of what? Joy. Amen. At his right hand, there are what? Pleasures evermore. Amen. So these scriptures are very, very vital. I don't know whether you meditate these things as you are, but in order for us to build ourselves up and come to the place where we will have the strength to help people, then we need to build ourselves up in what? Amen. On the holy, on the most holy faith, our most holy faith. Amen. Getting established in grace is something that we can do, and most of it we can do with our mouths as we affirm the word of God, or as we, amen, acknowledge, amen, all of the things that the Lord is what? Doing. All of the things that God said he is, amen, to us. We have to acknowledge. As I was saying this morning, we had a good time this morning. We had 9 people, amen, probably about as many as we had. How many do we have here? Amen. Somebody that can count real good. Turn around and just see how many do we have here. And I know we had 9 this morning. Amen. But I was mentioning this morning that there's a spouse in the home or a friend or somebody that's close to you, when you are consistently doing things for them, since consistently supporting them, giving moral support, giving financial support, and when you are there for them, and when you are, amen, lay down your life and suffer, go through adversity just to make life better for them, and they never acknowledge, amen, all of the sacrifices and all of the good things that you do for them. Amen. That makes somebody very sad. Amen. You know, for instance, like, you don't know how much prayer and how much time it takes, and you know, to pray and just to have something to say when you get up, trying to teach people or to preach to people or to pray with people. Amen. But how many people ever acknowledge, Pastor Hill, I really appreciate the word, I appreciate your faithfulness. I appreciate the sermon. I appreciate, you know, people just don't have a habit of acknowledging anything that nobody does as a whole. Amen. One person I can count on every Sunday, Sister Hill, and I can count on Sister Holman. Amen. I mean, I guess, you know, those are two that you can always count on, Pastor. Oh, I really appreciate it. I really enjoy it. Amen. That word was good. Amen. So it means so much to acknowledge the things that God's doing. And that's the thing that that determines the strength of your prayer. Why don't you just kind of pick that in? Amen. Bible says, blessed are the merciful, for they shall what? Obtain mercy. Amen. Blessed are the what? Merciful. They shall what? Obtain. Sister Sharon, amen, she says it a lot, amen, when she can get to me after church. Amen. I like her face when I preach. I like her face. Amen. What do I like about her face? Amen. Amen. She has revelation knowledge, and she understands what I'm saying. But sometimes people look at me like they don't even know what I'm talking about. So as he coming from, I don't know what he's talking about. Amen. You have to have ears to what? Hear what the Spirit of the Lord is what? Saying. Amen. So we want to get in the business of acknowledging all of the things that God said he is to us. If the Lord say, I'm a sun and a shield, I give grace and glory. Amen. And no good thing will I withhold from them that walketh upright. Amen. You need to what? Acknowledge that during the time that you are what? In his presence. Lord, you said you give grace and glory. No good thing. Amen. That enriches your faith and places you in a favorable position for God to what? Make that truth a reality in your life. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Yeah. So I think that, I don't know, I think that all of those scriptures, even the New Testament scriptures, is God's good pleasure to give you the kingdom. Amen. I usually try to say all of these things, and then I try to remember the kingdom of God is not meat and drink, but righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. That blesses me, amen, in the midst of my prayer, because, amen, the first part of it said the Lord, he has great pleasure in the prosperity of his servant. I mean, it's God's good pleasure. But I usually tie those scriptures together too. So you can tie a whole lot of scriptures together. And boy, you can just get as happy as you can be. Amen. That's the one, those are the two I tie together. I'm not going to tell you what they found. Amen. You probably wrote them down or something. And I hope you can go back and find it. But I'm going to have to probably get it and put it in the meditation book so you can keep up with it. All right, now, the Lord hath pleasure in the prosperity of his servant. Now, you can think about that. Then, it's God's good pleasure to give you the kingdom. So, now, both of those scriptures are saying that God is really eager and he wants to pour out his blessings upon you in a measure where you won't have room to receive. He wants to do it really, really, really bad. But suppose somebody that you're always doing something for, wanted you to do something really, really bad, and they want you to give them something, they had a real, real need that they wanted you to give them something, and they haven't acknowledged a whole lot of the things that they have received in the past. They've never showed any type of what? They've never expressed any type of what? Appreciation, a love, for the things that they have already received, you might be a little reluctant. Amen. I mean, all of us are human, right? You would be a little what? A little reluctant. You wouldn't be that excited. Amen. So we're saying that we just want you to really take these scriptures serious, because it's no mystery, amen, in prayer, if you put the right thing in, the right thing will come out. If you meditate these scriptures and these scriptures become real to you, I don't know, you know, if the area of God's word that pertains to his love and all of the things that he's eager to do and all these provisions he has made, Scripture says God didn't withhold his own son, but he delivered him up for us all. Yeah. So how shall we with him, amen, freely give us what? All things. So God wants us to have what? All things that he has provided for us, amen, through Christ. He wants us to have that in reality. Amen. Scripture says all things are ours. Amen. All things are ours. Amen. I want you to open your mouth. I've never heard very few of you say that. Say all things are ours.
All things are ours.
So all things are mine.
All things are mine.
Amen. So that's the reason why many times people feel like, well, I don't have nothing going. Life has dealt me a sour lemon. I don't have nothing going. Nothing works out for me. I'm seeing that the blessings always would escape me. But you have to what? You have to pull those blessings in and make those blessings what? Yours. And begin to acknowledge them. And begin to say all of these wonderful things.
Yes.
Amen. I'm going to say that again. Say all of these wonderful things that God has already what? Provided us through Christ. We have to what? Acknowledge them. Amen. I've come that you might have what? Life. Am like what? More abundantly. These are things that we can say and pull out the anointing and cause the anointing to be released in great measures in our lives. Amen. There's nothing wrong with looking down at your paper, reading from your book, and saying these things with your mouth. They have to come out of your mouth. Amen. Pray. There's no amen. Praise God. There's no special nothing about me. All I do is just what? I just what? Take the word. Amen. Whatever the word says, I try to what? Find the part of the word that shows that God really loves me and he has made all of these wonderful provisions for me. And I'm just simply what? Acknowledging these things. Or sometimes you might want to call it confessing these things that God has said about me. All right. So I want you to turn to this week and the following week, I want you to really begin to focus on the ministry of reconciliation. This is in the meditation book. And I want you to focus particularly, you can read all of it, but in the area of created in Christ Jesus unto good works. Amen. Created for good works. Okay. God has created us for a specific purpose. Ephesians 2:10. For scripture says, created in Christ Jesus unto good works which God had before that we should walk in them. I want you to meditate on that because he has fixed us or created or put into us everything that we need in order for us to be very effective in doing all of the things that he has called us to do. Those virtues and those blessings and those strengths have already been placed on the inside of us. And one thing that we can do to, amen, to make these virtues more active and to make them more meaningful even to us is that we have to acknowledge that I've been created, amen, I've been created, amen, to what? To do the works, amen, of the Lord, amen. I've been created. God has placed in me. I'm his workmanship. Everybody just open your mouth. Say, I'm God's workmanship.
I'm
the person that God is working through.
Amen.
Amen. Now, how many believe that if you would just open your mouth and say that? That's the first scripture in that particular session. How many believe that God will work even in a greater measure? Because you're acknowledging what God has made you. I'm his workmanship. Amen. So we don't have to feel beat down. We don't have to feel inferior. We don't have to feel like we're a loser. Everybody else got something going except me. Amen. God got all of this going for all of us. And he's just looking for the one. His eyes are just what? Waiting for someone to come into agreement with what he has what? Already done or what he has already said. That's all he's looking for. And when he finds somebody that's in agreement and says, yes, Lord, I'm your workmanship. Lift your hand up, might cry, holler, pray in the spirit. Amen. That thing will hit you and get to you sooner or later if you will what? Only acknowledge that you are what? I'm a vessel of honor and God is working in me.
his will and the ability to what? To do all that he has what? Called me to do. Amen. Praise God. Woo! Hallelujah. Why make myself happy? By myself. Look here. How many know his life in the Word?
Amen.
Scripture says life to them that what? Find it. That's where you find it. You pick out stuff in the Scripture that God said about you, and more that becomes powerful. Jesus even said this, the words that I speak are what? Spirit, and they are what? Life. Spirit and life. So these are scriptures you want to eat. You want to feed on. They'll make you great. They'll make you when you start reaching out. That's the motivation. Because we can't sit here until Jesus comes. They say he's going to come in December. I don't believe that. But amen, I believe that he's coming real soon. Okay, how many just want to sit right here? This is good enough. This is coming on Monday night prayer. Amen. But you want to use Monday night prayer to motivate you, to inspire you, to build you up and to get you established in faith, so that you can do wonderful things for God before he comes. I think wonderful things would even be just getting our families saved. Amen. There's a certain depth of prayer, certain commitment to prayer, certain relationship in prayer that's needed in order for you even to deal with your household. And how many know your household is really, really difficult? You're going to have what? You're going to have to be established in grace sometimes to even deal with people that's close to you. How many can say amen? How many would like to see all of their households saved?
Amen.
Amen. Now, many of you feel that, well, I ain't strong enough, amen, to get all of these rebellious and stubborn. These people, I mean, they're so messed up in this and that. Okay, but let me tell you how it works. See, God says that in unity there is what? Strength. See, one person alone perhaps can't get the job done in most cases, especially when these are cases in which are chronic and when they're deep-seated and when they're difficult. One person can't do it alone. That is the reason why in the New Testament, as they prayed, the Bible says that as they prayed, they were all on what? One accord. They all came together. Is that right? And the Bible said they were all on one accord. It says it over and over. They were united in prayer. Because, see, one can chase in 1,000, but two can put how many to a flight? 10,000. So Sister Pearl's power, and Sister Shirley, all of us combined together. Amen. When you put it all together, it is amplified many, many, many times. And that is the reason why in the New Testament, it was so many miracles, because the scripture says that they were all in one accord, they prayed until the place was shaken, and the Bible says great grace was upon them, boldness, amen. They spake the word of God with boldness, and they experienced signs and wonders and miracles. One case after they prayed like that. It wasn't just the one apostle alone that did that. It was everybody what? Praying together. Everybody put their little bit what? In the pot.
Yes. Amen.
See, if everybody just would pray, everybody would work on building myself up. Amen. Through the word. Speaking the word out. Agreeing with God. Acknowledging the things that God is doing in me, or the provision that God has made. Then our prayers will generate a lot more strength. Then all of the strength, all of the power will come in.